really bad team fights against him. But after a month, people adjusted. It's not so much the nerfs to Phoenix, in fact. I just think people understand how the hero works now and play around it.
Yeah, we have seen it in Manila. And the start of the group stage, he was like kind of doing okay. But as the tournament progressed, his win rate got worse and worse. He lost more and more games. And they were like really lopsided too. I think people just really figured out how to play against support Phoenix.
Just cracking the code, huh?
All right. Well, it looks like we have a Game 2 draft underway. So let's hop into it. It's OG versus TNC. It does look like it's going to be OG with the first pick. They banned out the Axe while TNC get rid of the Batrider here. So a lot of priority already on these offlaners, gentlemen. And who's going to set the stage for these fights? 5 seconds
remaining. I'm not really sure. What I'm wondering right now is how much confidence does OG have going into this? Because 4 games now, they've lost with Miracle Tinker, a hero that they previously thought they could always win with. They lost with, who was it the first game that he played? Timbersaw, a hero that he was also excellent at. Now they lost with the Medusa. It's like their cards are just being taken away from them now.
And at the same time, they also deny twice in a row now. TNC deny the Batrider, which I think is an outstanding hero for Moon. He makes so much happen every single time in the laning phase. And I think this is very smart by TNC because that allows aggression from OG. Now they're taking that away.
Are you guys surprised at all that they like ban out the first two picks of TNC last game, which was Axe and Titan? Like, it definitely speaks that they have like a lot of respect for them, surely.
It speaks volumes, and I think Elder Titan, he is one of the heroes who has the best record here at TI. He's been doing really great in group stages. I think only two heroes are possibly out, like Mirana and Terrorblade are two of the higher win rates, but
Elder Titan best win rate strong. May not be because a certain Waga has him on his predictions.
I was hoping he would win a little bit more, but he's up there. He's close.
So as far as OG reaching back to what used to work for him, I think Wisp is probably a top candidate there. They use that first pick priority and snag him up, but TNC really wastes no time at all and quickly grab the Vengeful Spirit and the Drow Ranger. Double auras.
Yeah, and you have to respect the Beastmaster now as well from Sam H. He plays a very good Beastmaster, so you should probably deny it. It's a natural combo as well, of course. Probably gonna be a removed by OG.
It's gonna be a bit dangerous though for TNC because Crit plays like a really, really aggressive Wiz. Usually when you don't expect him to be somewhere, he's always there and turns like the gank around. And I think if you run a draw lineup, the only thing that you really want to prevent is that your lane issue gets pressure too much. But Darkseer and Io FT, they can do like a really good job at pressuring them.
Yeah, I'm just wondering whether they're going to pair up as a combination with the Darkseer here. Of course, they could be going for a big AoE combo in the teamfight, but you need something early on that can make use of the Iron Shield as well. What do you think you're going to pair for?
I mean, I would have said Earth Spirit, but Crit is their Wisp player. But one time in the past, I have seen Fly pick up the Earth Spirit, but can you think of any other good candidates that might fit the Iron Shield early?
Spirit is not a hero anymore. He's gone.
Come on. Yeah. And he's right here on my jacket. What do you mean he's not a hero anymore?
He'll stay there.
He's gone for sure.
I think you can just take a lot of different melee cores to enable that hero anyways. I think the biggest thing is that it relieves a lot of pressure from the Io just because you're almost always going to have two or minimum three heroes up at top to deal with the Darkseer to try to enable Drow Ranger's laning phase. And for TNC, I do like this opener. It's very aggressive. It's something that a lot of teams got really comfortable with, just running the Drow. And for them to kind of represent saying, oh, you just ran it wrong, we can still win with it, is ballsy by TNC.
I haven't seen TNC run it a whole lot, but like, this could be a really decent Storm game already for Puku. But I'm not sure whether they play it or not.
At this rate, you're just saying that because Blitz is here on the panel and we always see a Storm whenever he's here joining us, but you're right. There is potential.
There's a possibility for later.
I think against Darkseer and Io, he's very good actually because neither of those heroes have hard lockdown. The burst damage isn't even really there for you as a Storm Spirit. We saw it earlier today in 2 games. I felt like they were both games that should have been successful. We saw a very good game from Sumail. That hero can still do what it used to as long as you get to that 3-item timing, but for TNC, I think it's a little bit too early. At earliest, they probably pick a 4th or 5th. Biggest thing I think is once you see what the second support is. If OG don't pick a stun, that's what's going to enable your Storm.
And second support, I think SD has to be on the table here as well. Of course, OG removing Beastmaster is natural, but now the SD is another like first pick material for some teams. And TNC really played well, and it goes with their draft as well. So are OG going to deny that, or do they not worry about SD here?
Usually when TNC picked SD really early was when they prioritized the Illusion heroes like Terrorblade, even Naga Siren occasionally. I'm not sure they run a lot of draw, and I'm not sure how good Vengeful and Shadow Demon are together for them, because they like to be like really, really aggressive. But it's definitely like a very good choice, especially against Darkseer. Like, he can't lane against the lane at all.
It also works in team fights later. When Darkseer tries to search away anyone, if you're quick with the perch, it has amazing cast range, you can just hold him there. But we'll see if they want to go for it. It's definitely... I feel it works pretty well with their starting picks.
What do you think about the ban on Naga? Is that just saying like OG might go for it as like a we really need to get a win kind of a thing? I know OG have ran it as a support in the past, but that was crit and they already have a wisp, so I would figure that TNC are banning it in the respect that it's a core Naga.
Yeah, I think in a game like this, big thing for TNC is they want to try to make it that this is going to be a familiar game to them. There's not a ultra superior late game hero, as Joe Ranger does kind of struggle with that Radiance Naga Siren, but for me, biggest question mark is what OG decided to go for Miracle, because he has lost with the heroes that previously OG probably thought were untouchable. The one hero that they were successful with so far in this tournament was that Invoker, which I kind of think that they want to go for, considering why would you ever go out without letting your
gentleman
player play his best hero?
We also can't forget Huskar is actually still out there.
Yeah.
Is that a concern at all? We have actually, I don't believe, seen it yet on the main stage at all. But eventually, you forget about him. Pops out.
Right now, OG are in those Houston's Ryland, right? They're sitting there with the Wisp and Darkseer and going, oh, we don't have stuff against Huskar, and right now, they could very well pick it on the side of TNC. So your next pick here, look towards heroes like maybe Timbersaw, actually. Pretty good at chasing down after a Drow, and also would be great against a Huskar if you're going to have to play against that. You just need pure damage to be added right now. And also interesting that Void is not picked up, so TNC have a great offlaner as well available as a fourth pick if they want to.
I really want to see a hero that can really abuse the Iron Shell a lot, and Ogre is definitely one of those heroes. He can just like ignite you and run you down. That's definitely a very good support for Darkseer to pressure the offlane. So we're probably going to see Wisp rotate between middle and safe lane, and they are most likely going to pick a safe there that can like sustain himself for OG.
So, Will, it does seem likely that this Ogre is going to be going to Fly, as we expect Crit, of course, to play as Wisp because he's so damn good on it. But Fly playing that more aggressive, bouncer-like support in the early game, as opposed to where we normally see him like a defensive support position, do you like him on one side or the other, or do you think he's just that talented of a guy that he could do it both ways?
I think it's okay, but usually I like to see him on one of those saving supports or the ones that have to play the positional game. Ogre's a little bit more straightforward than that. It's not really a support that you want to scale ultra late into the game with just because his spells do become a little bit underwhelming. Bloodlust is kind of always okay, but his spell kit kind of does fall off after a little bit. But for OG right now, biggest question for me still remains, what do you do with your cores? You have your support duo available, TNC. We talked about the Storm Spirit still being a hero. Huskar potentially be a pick. They could just run Dro, something like mid.
I just feel that for OG right now, they need to make something that makes good use of the Bloodlust. We talked about the Iron Shell and Ignite combo, but to me, it really feels like a Juggernaut game, but I don't know if he's going to be able to chase people down against this Vengeful with Swap, the Dazzle to Grave and save people, and then you have the Weave. The Omni Slash might not do that much if they get to prepare for the fight.
Alright, go ahead. You go ahead.
Oh, my point's not relevant. I said whatever they pick, I hope it's blue or along those lines because...
Good point, Dakota.
I mean,
that's my analyst.
I mean, you're right. Or they just go for a Tiny that we haven't seen for a very long time.
Alright, Tiny Wisp. We're gonna go ahead and flip it back a couple of pages.
Yeah, I mean... OG, Tiny Wisp, Notep was one of the first people to ever pick up that combo, and he definitely knows how to run it. He knows how to run it very, very well. His Tiny is one of the best in the business, so that's definitely one of the more aggressive combos, and I really like that they're running it. And that means they're gonna probably give... 5 seconds like Notep plays a hero, right?
Yeah, but the thing is, Notep is so used to playing the Wisp in that combo as well. That's why he's so good at playing this.
Yep.
Because he, for years, played the Wisp with the Tiny, so he knows exactly what's needed from the Tiny and from the Wisp at different times.
But do you think then they're gonna put Miracle solo safe lane, or are they actually gonna put the hero solo mid and then Tiny Wisp safe lane?
I think they need to see the entire draft before they decide, actually, because we don't really know what TNC have as their second important core here, as Void is often, you only know the Drow Ranger. I think they need more info.
it could potentially still be a carry void as well with a draw on mid and maybe pick something like an offlane profit, still possible to ramp up the push power.
I'm just scared Void doesn't really want to lane against the Iron Shield, so I think you still want to go for something like the draw against Darkseer pairing if you're TNC right now. But they have a lot of different options, and Invoker does get removed.
Okay.
Turn to pick.
I mean, it doesn't make use of the Bloodlust, so you really only have one hero in your team that makes use of the attack speed. The movement speed is nice, I guess, for everyone, though.
It does mean TNC, they don't have the best disables for this Ember Spirit, just because if he gets maybe two items, he's going to be pretty mobile, especially with the Blink Dagger. For them, it's going to come down to the Faceless Void's Chrono, but oftentimes if the Ember spots any sign of it, you can instantly get out. I think TNC need a mid hero that can gap close, or at least get to the same kind of scaling range as an Ember Spirit, because I think TNC, just in case, want to be able to go to the late game with OG.
I'm just a bit afraid for OG, because if the laning phase doesn't go really, really well for them, they won't have enough damage to deal with that push.
Oh, there he is!
Oh, God!
There he is!
We know that face.
We know that face so well. He's just been lurking in the back, and he finally shows himself with Will TNC's Huskar lineup. Is it going to cheese their way into the next round?
Tiny, when he gets really strong, can do somewhat okay, but at the same time, I think Ember is too slow at dealing with Huskar. I think TNC can actually do this.
Yeah, I spoke about OG's lack of damage, and now that Huskar's there, I feel like it's even more true than before. So I actually think TNC have the better draft, and they might actually take this 2-0.
Yeah, I never expected to say it, but I think TNC might shut out OG here in this series.
Wow, will they be the new Orange Esports of TI3? We'll have to find out. We'll throw it over to our casters right now. It's Toby Wan and Merlini. Take it away.
TNC are pulling out one of the most successful combinations. You got your Dazzle and Huskar together. You buff it up with a Drow Ranger. This is what they're bringing to the field. OG go Classico with their Tiny and Whisk combination, combining it with Moon's Darkseer. Both teams have a lot to work with, but the panel seems to be pretty well tilted towards TNC.
They have the Huskar. We haven't seen it. We talked a lot about it, and we're like, oh, they're probably going to pick it, but man, Toby, you've been blessed with two Drow Ranger games in a row.
Yeah, yeah, maybe this one's going to be a Victra.
What do you think about that new Drow Immortal?
It's really, really nice, but be careful. It actually reveals your position. Just a small little warning with particle effects. Looking out for my fellow Drow players. TNC, very aggressive movement already. They instantly ward block up, and at the same time, okay, yeah, they get vision inside all over the OG jungle. They take out two of the camps very early on. They're going to see OG's maneuvers very, very closely. No easy stacks, no easy farm, no easy way for Moon just to abandon the offlane and get fast levels in the jungle. He has to play the lane.
Yeah, and I think also Ember Spirit's going to struggle a lot. I'm not sure if he has a place in this game with how fast-paced generally Drow lineups are, and even faster with a Huskar. Like, you want a Battle Fury defending against the push, but you might lose the game before then.
Maybe that's when you look back towards the old-school combat-style builds you get on Miracle.
Yeah,
like, I know BKB Destin was a very long time ago with the Ember, but
you might have to go Tread this game.
Is that the way?
Tread door phase. We saw that a little bit last year, but it's overwhelmingly BOTs now, but I think in this sort of game, you might need something else. I don't know, they have the Wisp.
Yeah, he's going to have the early help from the Wisp. Like, normally we pair the Io and the Tiny together, but no tell we headed up to the top lane. Normally a little bit safer, but you also see the way TNC have moved their lanes around. They push the Drow and the Dazzle
for
this dual almost try off lane with a Roaming Vengeful Spirit, which puts the Faceless Void on the bot lane to start this off. And already OG, they're switching everything up. They bring their two supports up to the top lane and leave Moon going up against the Void. He's hunting into the trees to try and find Jimmy. He actually goes to the old school classic Jimmy Tidehunter spot up in those trees, but he's not gonna find him. Is that his fly? Oh, he's trying to body block up Raven. Not enough controls, actually a kill going on. Miracle of all, it's the mid lane that finds the first blood. They're still chasing down Crit on the top lane. This OG safe lane will survive, but Miracle first blood? Ember was already gonna have a hard enough a time as it is. Oh, the Avalanche, it connects. Demon, too low. The Shadow Wave, one more attack. It actually comes in from Crit to find it. VS makes his way up, looking for the stun onto Notown. He's already pretty low, and Raven, no Cold Arrows, no Gust. He doesn't really have any disable and control of his own, just the damage buff up. So, a quick rebuttal kill from OG.
Ogre is the man. He can just bully everyone out of this lane, though. Even all the right-click damage and Drow Ranger have had enough.
Switching. So Raven comes to the bottom lane. Faceless Boy will have to buy a TP scroll and go north. He wants to be matched up against No-Tail.
I think No-Tail is one of the best tinies. His Wisp play, I think last year when he played support, just amazed me. And he just knows the limit of this combination very well.
How is Miracle meant to be in this lane? Like, it's an underleveled Ember Spirit because you gave away first blood. So you're a full level, almost a full level behind that of the Half Guy. And then he does this.
Illusion.
Pull the steering arrow, his stacks, you burn down. You are nowhere near a bottle on this Ember. And the IO was also not capable of rushing a bottle early on. So Crit doesn't have a lot of regeneration to give Miracle.
They can always kind of TP the Wisp in, maybe with a bottle of the Wisp and the bottle of the Ember. You have like a quadruple bottle kind of with a tether. So it can be salvaged. It just depends on whether they think the Aya would be better suited in another lane, or they can just stack for him. He can take out some stacks with the Flame Guard. But yeah, the early lane phase is just an absolute nightmare dealing with Huskar on top of Huskar without Aura.
I'm wondering if it was the greatest decision as well. Like, why not put the IO Tiny into the mid lane up against Huskar? Have that regeneration, have that rune control arrive for OG.
Nah, just maybe you're thinking that Ember's like just needs the levels a little bit more. They can also stack much easier, I think, if the IO's in the top lane because of that Observer Ward that has blocked out OG.
Avalanche gonna start with, need to keep that combo going. Ignite really good up against the Faceless Void. No-Tail's looking for a toss back if possible. But he grabs the wrong hero, sends Fly back over towards Crit.
Oof, that's rough.
Wide to have that chip damage, maybe trigger the south. He goes again. Avalanche, TP support being baited out now from the Dazzle. As a throw up and towards the air, Faces Void, time walks off the damage. And with a Shadow Wave, No-Tail, surrounded very heavily by creeps and heroes. So, cops a lot from Demon.
Value salve right there, though. And TNC want to keep track of the stacking game. I think that's actually why they started off top, just to make sure that like they can invade the jungle very, very easily if they have a free support up on that top lane. Both supports, like they are in this top area, just realizing that, okay, the Wisp and the Tiny and the Ember are going to need stacks.
Hey, Strun. We saw Demon make the most out of it before. Fly, he's just harassing the Dazzle down.
Oh, they were just waiting for him. That was a trap.
Yep.
And but they
have fall for it.
Yeah, that was ever worked.
Is Moon killing Raven as well? He doesn't. He actually had Surge, potentially could have dived for it, but Moon's just happy being the Drow Ranger low on life.
Yeah, and Raven's not actually absorbing the XP from those large camps, too, so Moon's gonna get way more from this lane. He's already one full level ahead of Raven because of the lane swap.
Raven still found a decent amount of CS. Obviously, the experience is also like the critical part for a Drow Ranger. You want that early level 6, it's just going to amplify everything else the Huskar's doing to Miracle.
They don't have vision on the high ground, so with the cover of nighttime, Miracle can actually farm a decent bit, do level 3 Flame Guard, make sure that he still has a reasonable amount of HP, and I think his CS is actually pretty decent in this lane. 9 CS versus 25 Huskar. Like, Huskar sometimes like shut out the melee mid laner.
Sad situation though, when you say 9 CS for a mid laner 5 minutes in is a good thing. And it could have been worse after that one death. It was very early on. And No-Tail continues to farm up. He's already completed up the treads. He looks like they got a bottle over on Crit. All levels over on him too. Got to be scared of the time when OG come online with a relocate. Because Moon's also found a lot of levels, OG can look to try it and take some fights early on, and in fact with a double smoke, Crit and Fly, they're headed down south for exactly that, but they may be too late. The VS is roaming around. Moon is like, he was right between the Fog of War lines. So you can set up if you want to, but Fly will arrive, Crit will join, the Iron Shell, you put one onto the Ogre, need to slow down the VS with a gust from the Drow Ranger, they push them back, Cold Arrows as well, keeping him away, but then the stun, Vengeful Spirit's gonna burn up the Iron Shell, but the Shallow Grave from Demon, perfect time, Crit will die, the VS gets back in range of the safety of the T1 tower, now it's Demon, who's still in a little bit of trouble, he will finally drop, Fly looking for more thunders, Moon makes a break for the tree line, Fly, he needs more damage with the Iron Shell, he's almost got it, Raven needs to run, he's attracted the creep wave into the troll. The bash is there as a double kill for Fly.
Wow, it's actually so hard to see the Ion Shell on the Ogre.
He solo killed the Huskar. It looks like it was the heavy spirit committal.
Wow, That's a matchup that's like nearly impossible to win. That's like an 85, you know, 90 matchup favor in favor of the Huskar. But yeah, did you even know that Ayesha was on the Ogre? I could barely see. I saw it with the buff.
It's impossible to see. Like, the buff was the only way to look at it.
Yeah. I think TNC might have actually been caught off guard by that. Like, Dazzle ticked down because of that. And now, OG with the firm control of the bottom lane, Reserve Ward behind the tower. And mid lane, yeah, this was supposed to be a nightmare matchup. Now, CS is up to 19.
It's still not a dream for Miracle, but it's the fact he could catch up enough
that
his net worth is behind by 600. And he's running a bottle. Bottom lane, I'll just dive into Raven. Three heroes from OG. Where's the TP support coming this time around? There's no TP over on Demon. They just let the Drow Ranger die. OG really taking advantage of this big strength they've got, aka life sustain.
The Ogre's a really big problem. He like one top lane for them, he one bottom lane for them. And now mid lane, I guess, kind of won because Miracle already got a return kill. He's actually going for Cuckoo right now.
Enough damage just yet. Letting the flame guard do the work.
And TNC's Observer Wards have been wasted. They've placed two in the middle lane, but Miracle really has not gotten any support and hasn't needed it, it seems like. And then they don't have any eyes on the bottom lane where OG are making all their moves and may just give a free tower.
This is a much-needed goal for OG. This allows Nortel, if he wants, to be really aggressive. Especially wondering how Nortel wants to build this. Do you look towards the Blink Dagger early on? Do you look to build up more money? Is there an easier way to slip in? Like, Shadow Blade is another item he's gone on tiny in the past.
Miracle likes to go Shadow Blade and Blink, so I think Nortel might do the same thing. I think Silver Edge is incredibly good versus the Huskar. And I think the added burst from the Shadow Blade is also really good at killing a Faceless Void before he can time walk.
King of Huskar. Huskar's roaming over. There's a Radiant Sentry Ward down. There's also a decent stack. He's gonna... Oh, they smoke, and the smoke instantly broke on Fly. So TNC understands the movement was coming from OG under the cover of smoke. Don't find their opening. In fact, it's gonna be TNC who finds it on Mooney. Had his surge up. The stun's not lasting long enough.
That level 2 surge paying off. Nortel trying to go up there.
Cuckoo's finally revealed himself. He was missing from the mid lane, that's what OG was looking for. But the invis rune that allowed him to stay hidden. And Nortel, he's gonna toss in Fly, which will allow for the follow-up stun. They keep the control with the Avalanche and Cuckoo! They burn through him again! And OG, there's a reason why teams are scared of letting them have Io. Let alone the combination with the Io and Tiny. This is it.
I think another thing that might have contributed to Huskar losing the lane is actually not maxing out the Burning Spears. At level 7, he had only level 2 Burning Spears. He picked up the third point at level 8, but I think that damage is just incredibly good. You don't really need too much magic resistance because you're versus a hero that shouldn't really be able to get close to you.
If TNC have any desire to fight that mid lane, they need the TPs to come in earlier. Faceless Void was in a really good position for a chrono.
Well, Drow strength getting pushed in? Not good.
Probably not. Especially when Raven's gone for, like, the heavy stat item build. Like, double Rage Band, still got an extra circlet. Miracle, easy maneuver. Can close the distance on a Drow Ranger with ease. And then actually leaves his spirit underneath the tier 1 tower on the top lane.
Yep,
and that's why ROG is coming. They want to take out another tier 1.
Well, they've gotten, like, this is extremely bad for TNC. Like, they have a Drow, they have a Huskar, they were supposed to win probably all three lanes, winning two is fine too, but I believe they lost all three of them. And now, like, Miracle has gotten past the hardest part of the game as an Ember Spirit, and you can actually go back to a normal build now because you're not actually scared of TNC snowballing out of control. You're taking down the third T1 tower, TNC can't put up a fight. Like, on the maybe on the back of a good chrono, maybe they can get some kills, but the normal trajectory of taking out T1, the Roshan has just been completely stolen away from them.
And I still can't believe we were looking at the draw from TNC saying, hey, this could really work. Miracle getting Solo killed early on by the Huskar. The early kills for TNC, things looked like they were working.
Port rotations were really strong, especially from Fly. Like having an early TP at the start, so he went to the top lane and neutralized the threat of the Metro Spear and the Dazzle. And then, like going to the bottom lane, Radiant's making sure that the Darksteer was safe. Like all these just really added up to OG having a huge lead. 5,000 gold.
Unbelievable. We're 11 minutes in. Huskar does have his armlet, so there's a little bit more survivability potentially from Cuckoo coming into the fights. They still haven't found a good use for that Chronosphere. They'll sentry up, look to smoke up. There is no vision for OG. In fact, they've only got one ward on the Radiant side of the river, and that's all the way down in bottom lane. Their best target is Miracle. At the same time, you always assume he's got a Spirit right behind him.
Yeah, I don't think Sam wants to go for this. Very high probability of the dodge coming out.
Problem, right? Yeah, your life break in and all of a sudden slide a fist.
Now they're going to have to deal with a threat from Shadowblade on the Tiny coming up very soon. He just needs a couple hundred gold. And now, like, all those early Observer Wards have been taken down, so they can farm up stacks at their leisure.
Dream stop for OG. They just have to hold at 5,000 advantage. We've seen them in this position before. And where are they going? They actually headed south. They're right in front of Roshan, but TNC is very much grouped up looking for a fight on top.
They're just farming. They're okay with farming. The longer this goes, the worse and worse it gets for TNC.
Especially considering Moon is able to hold back this way with some good iron shells. He's almost got enough full mech. A recipe in before he's even finished up the headdress or the buckler.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
No, they're gonna let it go. It looks like they're gonna let it go. Miracle
they're waiting for Tiny. And Tiny's gonna smoke in. Looks like he has Bloodlust. He has Shadowblade. I don't believe TNC have any.
There's no sentries down. They won't understand that Notar's right on top of him. VS is in the tree line. Sons of Valve, they just pass the drone under the T1 tower. Darkseid wall. Who's gonna use the damage from that to find the kill? And now Cuckoo. Life breaks up. A great Chrono is catching three on the back line. This will give TNC a chance. And Cuckoo with a Shallow Grave. He'll stand his ground, but down be brought down. OG, they may just have the sustain required to win this fight as they get the extra stun. Poor loss for TNC. Miracle arrives in the nick of time.
That was a really important point where he had an armlet toggle, and they killed him while he was armlet toggling, and that was just the end of the fight. Like it was a nice grave coming out, and he did a lot of damage. He was able to kill the IO, but if he dies immediately after the grave, they've lost the fight, especially with how far behind they are. Now they have BOTs up on Ember, they can easily split push and just take ganks around. So replay coming out, Drow immediately eliminated from the fight, not that big of a deal. Then Huskar, here we see the grave coming out, nice.
You thought the Chrono might have been enough for Cuckoo to do the work, but Miracle just, like, a quick jump out, So survivable. The Iron Shells were racked up as well.
I don't even think it's possible to armor toggle through Flame Guard and Iron Shell. So, I don't even think there was any window for TNC to win the fight, aside from maybe killing multiple cores during the Chronosphere.
TNC is looking for an opening of their own. They're going to loop around. They're hoping to take out Roshan. This will be very advantageous if they can complete it. And yep, they're slipping in. Moon's in the neighborhood. He's gonna break the smoke, so they realize that someone is out there. But that's also because the Observer Ward is planted. They're doing it right under the nose of OG. Observers and sentries planted just in case there's any invis detection.
Well, the more behind you get, the more crazy risk that you take. There are 10,000 gold in the hole, and this would be a nice pick-me-up for Cuckoo.
It's crazy to think they don't know. Like, there's no Chronosphere, so you wouldn't think at OG that they would slip in, but there it is. Aegis the Immortal, it goes the way of the Huskar.
However, they're isolated. Three of them out on their own. Moon.
He puts down the wall. He'll get a couple of illusions. The life break fall from Cuckoo. No tell in through the rear. However, Avalanche Top say goodbye to the Aegis Immortal Demon. Already used the Grave on himself. Still with a couple of one-charters. Won't connect them. And now Cuckoo. Sam, he has to let the Chronosphere go, but they're all outside of it. They can move over towards Moon. But then he's so dead. He wants to fight this one. Miracle's already got a triple kill. There's none of his steering chains up for another 1 second. No way to toss him forward. But he'll have his spirit up if he wants to jump towards the Faceless Void. Time Walk is off cooldown at 1 second time. If Miracle gets there, the Time Walk will allow him to get back in range of the tier 3. So Miracle will just have to settle for a triple kill.
Only a triple kill. There goes that Aegis, and there goes any sort of pick-me-up that TNC might have mustered in the last couple of minutes. OG will systematically press their advantage, and the problem is they can't 5-on-5 right now because they're way too far behind the network, but they also can't split push because Ember Spirit with BOTs and an IO relocate and the Shadowblade on the Tiny, like, no one is really safe to farm out alone. Normally that's how you would get back in the game, farm out, try and play around the trees, TP out when you're thinking about the gank you, take down some towers, but they cannot do that this game, not without incurring heavy casualties.
Now all they can do is 5-man and hope they find one hero isolated without OG, like, every support coming in. You're always going to have 3 heroes, you just hope you don't have 5. Okay, Cuckoo. He just blatantly walks up to Miracle, trying to man-find him in the mid. There was support there from OG. TNC are well aware of this because they still have those 2 obstacles wards down, which they put down for Roshan.
Oh god, the blink on the Darkseer and the Silver Edge rush from Tiny. Huskar is going to be completely useless, grave or no grave.
Sometimes cheese can go off. Why? Oh, Miracle, do you want it? He still doesn't have the battle fury completed on this Ember Spirit.
Well, coming in from behind, no tail and crit.
Yeah, he's gonna find the Vengeance Spirit in the tree lines. One punch and an avalanche is almost, it actually is enough. Combine it with a toss just to be sure. Miracle, nice hearing chain, Cuckoo, Shallow Grave very early on. No Chronos Spear, it's a long cooldown for another 6 seconds here. Shallow Grave wears off on Huskar.
I have to be careful of the blink. Darkseer initiation, especially with that ward setup, TNC have no idea that there's this deep, deep ward scouting them out. And if they like combo that with a tiny, it's likely game over from there. So TNC, I don't know what they're gonna do about this.
The rock in a hard place. It's kind of the same situation OG was in game one, except a lot earlier in the game. They lost momentum, they lost the lanes. That middle lane was looking really good for Cuckoo, like almost a full level above the Ember, but Miracle waited out perfectly, and that one death he had to Cuckoo early on has been his only death of the game. He followed up with 7 kills, 3 assists, no casualties, and the top 3 net worth easily belonged to OG.
Uh-oh. Bly gets wind of this huge stack, probably communicating with his team about how to deal with this best.
It's like, Miracle, have you got your Battle Fury yet?
Nope, and no act on Tiny, so they can't take it out very easily, but they could jump them, maybe waiting for a scan around that moment, but...
They need an Observer Ward on the hill, probably.
Yeah, well, I think they know that they're about to take it right now. Draw Ranger with a Dragon Lance.
But they still ready to move.
Well, they can relook it from behind, or maybe they'll just try and drag him away due to the split push threat from Tiny.
Yeah, Nurtel beating into that tier 3 tower on the bot lane while almost all of TNC is here, and in fact, Cuckoo's abandoned it.
I think they might relocate him right now, though. Now that Huskar's gone, I think they can just wrap around from the side, but they need vision.
TNC's got the better vision, but in comes Miracle. Still no opening just yet, Nurtel. Moved into that cover of the Silver Edge, walking right behind Cuckoo. There's no sentry wards, there's just the towers that I have to rely on. And with a tether, he'll run in, avalanche, throwing Cuckoo back out again. It's a good chrono position for Sen, but he's still waiting for it. Now he gets it. The Shallow Grave will keep Huskar up. 4 heroes from OG caught out. They try and swap into a safe position. Now he leads back in. Rhymes up with Nurtel. Cuckoo can't toggle it, however. There's too many iron shells up. There's still a 1-for-1 trade-off. Make that 1-for-2. The Vengeful Spirit will fall as well. Miracle copy, too much damage from this Draw Ranger. Very, very low. Faceless Void needs a time lock as well if you can find this kill over on crit as the fight will separate. They're around the Ancient. The Slide of Fist. This will actually keep Miracle out of the fight for a little bit longer until Void moves over. Not in range for a punch. It's crit down south. Miracle up north. He's turning around with the Spirit damage to the Slide of Fist. Demons even so low. They Shadow Wave where they bring down Miracle. And they'll bring down crit as well. TNC. Repelling OG. Moon lucky to survive, TPing out a little bit further up on the top lane.
They got just way too antsy right now. The Silver Edge didn't hit on the Huskar, so he actually wasn't gonna die from that. Unless they stopped the supports from coming in. That was the idea. Talking back, make sure the supports can't come in for the grave, for the swap.
Mid lane, they go again. The Silver Edge hit into the Faceless Void, and it wasn't the Huskar. And the Hotel has to run away. Silver Edge still on cooldown for a little bit longer. But they're trying to go for a quick pop. Didn't find one.
And Ember also didn't respect the gust from the Draw Ranger. Doesn't have a good way out of that at the moment and will not for quite some time. And now TNC have free access to their Ancients. Good way to start.
Hey, easy cleanup. Add more money into the droves. Like, you finish up the Dragon Lance, there's a Wraith Band on the ground. And that's because it's delivering in a Yasha. keep in mind that TNC has a big amplification of damage. Miracle looking for an opening in mid. Sentry is down. There's no one invising close. No observer wards as well.
Totally.
And they are. Oh, wow, really? Really? Raven just slipped around the side. Almost to his farm. And the side of Fist Searing Chain didn't connect from Miracle. The chrono is up in 6 seconds. OG must be careful here. Might almost be worth it. She doesn't have Surge. You've only got Greaves up. Now, the tether forward. Crit does have relocate, but a three-man chrono. Sam hits it. Miracle wants to try and fight, but they're probably going to lose. Crit knows the Greaves, and the one charges. Raven finally gets it close enough to find the kill. The two-for-one trade-off, they move around the Darkseer wall. Miracle back in the game. A double Searing Chain. They have enough. Piney comes back in again, too. Surged up, Iron Shell into Silver Edge. Where's that sentry? There are two of them down. He'll get the avalanche. The stun is there. Slide of Fist. It is going to be enough damage to get through the Faceless Void, but the throws on the back line. Peppering OG down.
Wow, what team fight coming out from TNC. That was like one of those chronos that you're afraid, like if you miss, you'll hit zero, but if you hit it, you get three of them. That was just what they needed. And perfect gust coming out from the Drow Ranger too. He just waits for Miracle to overextend just a tiny bit. It's only a level one gust. Well, actually now it's level three, but it was only level one gust for the last two fights. And within that 3 second time frame, they were able to kill Miracle twice now.
This.
They've recovered and then some.
Oh yeah, they were 11,000 gold behind, and now it's rapidly approaching the 4K experience behind. It was just over 12,000 gold. It's up to 8. The comeback is real for TNC, but it is definitely not in full motion. You've still got a lot of things going the way of OG.
If they get a Roche, you can count them back in the game. Until then, they're still kind of working up till that.
Well, Roshan's in 2 minutes. Your split push is going to get better too. Miracle actually finished up his BTs before he finished up his Battle Fury. But it looks like they're going to keep these side lanes pressured in and keep TNC looking behind themselves all the time. Oh, life break. Not really going to have any effect as Miracle goes all the way back to base. Zotel's also rapidly approaching his Aghanim Scepter, 2 grand away.
They still need more stacks for them though. They haven't really had time to stack the Ancients or really stack too many other camps. Been just a lot of brawling going on. It's also very useful for the Ember Spirit to accelerate his farm towards a Crystallis or whatever it may be after his initial Battle Fury. Although this game might be better to get Manta style common item versus the Gust from Drow Ranger if you're scared of dying within a silence, which has happened to him multiple times this game.
Dyer's top tower is under attack.
Dyer's choice in a bit for now, TNC, to take out only their second tower of this game. 24 Dyer's minutes in, the top tier 1 will fall. But Notel's down the bottom lane, pressuring the tier 3. TNC must turn back.
I'm more curious as to what the Faceless Void's gonna build. He has a fair amount of gold right now, and he has Vlad's right now, so his options are Defusal, which common if you actually need to do damage, but I don't think you need to do damage as the Faceless Void this game. He has a Drow Ranger and he has a Huskar. As long as Huskar stays alive, you have all the damage that you need. So your other options are Blink Dagger. You'll sometimes see a Shadow Blade to catch out the Ember Spirit, because Blink's much worse than a Shadow Blade, because you want to scout him out, and maybe if he doesn't expect that he has Vision, you'll get caught out. What else could you see from Faceless Void? And you also see Scepter sometimes because of, like, they have to fight around the Chronosphere a lot this game, and they need to enable the Huskar to actually do damage. So, not sure which of the three best for him.
Chrono is exactly what she wants to buy. Arcane fight gets completed, already has the S and Y. And a lot of Drows go for more Aghanim Scepters, but this Dro, it's all about the Hurricane Pike.
X Maelstrom's like a late game build. Maelstrom's like a decent catch-up item too. Well,
the spirit jump from Miracle broke the smoke on Demon. So they realize that TNC is moving through the mid lane. Funny thing is, like, it would have broken everybody if they stuck the original plan. Now in Roshan. Where is OG? Where is the look? They just keep the flip push going. The ping's coming out. They have to realize what is going on, but how do you stop this? You got no easy way to sit inside the pit apart from a slide of fist, but it's already done. The Observe Ward didn't see the smoked up TNC going into the pit, and that is another Aegis the Immortal into the hands of TNC onto the Huskar.
thought that was an okay time for them to fight. They just got the Battle Fury and Ember Spirit, they have the DD, but just not really having any vision inside the pit. TNC, two smokes for Orochi, two great successes for them. There's no ET, no HOD carrier on the side of OG. They just don't have a good way to get vision inside the pit, whereas TNC, they just parked the Huskar HOD creep inside of there to make sure that they knew when Roshan was up.
If you're OG, maybe you're not really that sad about that. Like, okay, Aegis will come, but as long as the Ember can keep the side lane pushed out, damage is TNC going to do to you. You're farming up nicely across the map, you're still finding Radiance your objective timings for attack. Items.
I think you're sad from that. Maybe not like gearing up, like, you know, falling in your room.
It's not like OG loses and then we all have to cry kind of thing.
It's more like they have to commit a lot on the Huskar, because Huskar is like the key hero in this fight. They're going to throw like defensive swaps on him, Graves, Weaves, like four staff him out, Chrono around him. They're going to do like so many things to Huskar to save him. And if you overcommit and like, you know, they mess up one of the spells and then he has Aegis and then he survives, does his round two of whatever, you know, nonsense burning spears that Huskar does, then you're going to lose the fight badly.
Which means you just have to wait it out. You keep all the side lanes pushed out. But TNC hasn't really like claimed OG's jungle. They're still moving through ancients quite easily. Haven't seen the OG farm stop. If you actually look at the gold graph, it's swinging back down again in favor of OG, even after Roshan goes the way of TNC.
Yeah.
They're just making more out of the map.
They're out farming them for sure, but there's always that like one point in the moment in the fight, like, okay, are they going to actually kill Huskar? And then he might armlet toggle it, Intervit might heal him up through it, he might lifesteal through it. Like, he's probably going to build a satanic later. There's so many things that can go wrong for the fight that Huskar is like, oh crap, he was at 100 HP, he gets grave, he intervits, and then he armlets up, and then he's suddenly at 1000 HP, and everyone has to turn tail and run. So I think really the key hero for this fight is Darkseer. Darkseer has to be the one to like blink in the back, vacuum the supports, so they can't actually keep their distance away. Like, he is the most important hero, I think, on OG. Maybe like Ember Spirit is right now, but oh.
He finds the Vengeful Spirit, the Tentacons fall, where they still find the kill. Raven focusing on killing Crit. After getting a double silence, he understands that No-Tail's not really going to pop anything else on him.
No-Tail's also a really important hero in this, because he needs to make sure that they all keep like under-farmed and they retain this net worth advantage through virtue of pickoffs.
Are they actually going to go through the top? Top picks up a Hyperstone, so increased attack speed to go along with that Aghanim Scepter and Silver Edge. Miracle's already got the lane pushing in. The tier 2 towers are going to be the easier target. The double Iron Shells from Moon already pushed the creep wave onto the tier 2 tower, so yep, No-Tail.
I don't know if you want to fight into the Huskar or Aegis though. You have relocate, but the fight's going to last longer than 12 seconds. And Ventral Spirit is dead, Radiant's but only for a few more seconds. So I don't think they can claim the T2 tower off this. Unless Huskar is elsewhere. He doesn't actually have a TV score right now, so they can easily fight around his lack of mobility. They have eyes on top. They have a Sentry Ward as well to keep track of No-Tail. And they know that Wiz is hiding on the side. I don't know how they're going to approach it though. Looks like Ventral Spirit maybe like looking for a wave in a swamp. They know exactly where Wisp is this fight.
That is the reason why they're also sitting behind Raven. Raven is the biggest bait at the moment. The only upside will be, okay, the creep wave's out of attack to No-Tail. He understands they got vision. The swap out, relocate from crit. This will end up saving No-Tail. They were prepared for this, but you look down the bottom lane. Miracle is attacking the tier 3 towers. Moon's here to help them out. And the rest of TNC, they're still waiting for Io to return to the top lane. Too early on the gust from Raven. It won't matter. Crit will drop. But that bottom tier 3 tower now down to 276.
I think they actually should have committed the Chronosphere for that fight. Like Chrono on the left side, because they knew where he was. He walked right underneath the reserve reward and was hiding in the trees for quite some time. So you Chronosphere here and you just kill the Tiny and then you kill the Wisp. Like not that big. The only problem is you have to commit Chronosphere. And you might miss because it's in the fog,
time
but I think that would have been a much better plan than what happened. They had no plans to control the Io. Maybe they thought that like he might walk into a Chronosphere or something like that, but Crit was just waiting for that moment. Not worth all that damage on your T3. And on top of that, the Aegis is going to expire. I think you can just use the Aegis to like tank a push in case they try and push when Chronosphere is down.
20 seconds on it, so enough time to do anything. OG is all the way from that Aegis. Things. A sentry ward on bottom lane. Cuckoo's just far enough away that if No-Tail considers it, he could make a run. He'd actually have to go into Silver Edge pretty early on, primarily because the Observer Ward will have a very close look at him. Also note too that Roshan's gonna be a very quick spawn within the first 10 seconds of the 3 potential minutes of Roshan.
And this time the HOD creep is sitting right next to him, this trusty little Cardi at his side.
Convert from OG.
They don't have anyone to relocate in, so this is like a... they're just waiting for perhaps more people. And Miracle has another double damage, so this next fight could be go really poorly for TNC.
He's also finished his Manta, it's coming on the courier.
Oh wow. I don't know, I got so much farm after the Battle Fury.
They gave him space. Yeah. Like, when was the last time we saw TNC really pressure OG? Being OG being freely moving wherever the hell they want, TNC are only now, like 32 minutes in, taking this Dyer's T1 tower on the bot lane. Which looks like a big objective, but that's only because of the blood loss. It's a very easy one. And then mid lane, Notel's pushing in, Miracle's coming through the top. You take the T1 and you already got to back up. Unless you want to have heavy damage done to your buildings.
Void perhaps looking for a Chronosphere.
BS can't get there in time. Notel being very defensive. Bottom lane, Miracle. He gets it with the double damage to work. Mana style sends the two illusions back over the creep. And then spirits away up to the top lane.
Now Demon Cuckoo caught out by their lonesome. As their TP's worth of rotated back and they are just dead.
And Moon was the bait. Cuckoo tried to turn on the damage. But it's too much. This is the problem when OG can bring in so much support so quickly. Creep generation. Moon almost impossible to kill. Greaves, as well as having a Lotus Orb.
They're limited on bots right now. At least on the Huskar. It's not really ideal for him to walk around with the TP scroll if he can have an Aegis in his inventory. But at the same time, now they're getting picked apart by the split push. Like Tiny does a lot of damage to towers, and Ember does too if he has a double damage. Can't really ignore it anymore, especially with the T3 already down on the bottom lane, tops at half HP, like, their base is kind of in shambles.
You went for me? I'm gonna Blink Dagger for crit on an Ire. Tether is just not enough range for him.
You can do the super long tether, or like the... I'm not sure if that Wisp trick was patched, but you like tether, and then you blink at a specific time, and then you have like a double tether range. Radiant's I don't top really play Wisp. Maybe I'll start once the Arcana gets voted through, but right now, like I've seen it done before, but I don't exactly know how it's done or the mechanics of it. I don't even know if it's still in the game, but I definitely saw it at one point.
We might get a perfect example from Crit in just a bit, so we can keep our eyes on him.
Yeah, it's also probably likely to just dodge a Chronosphere or dodge a Huskar ulting at him. They don't really have a good way to stop blinks at the moment. Nothing instantaneous, actually, on their side.
Roshan's up in 1 second, and already TNC. They implement smoke maneuver through their own jungle, but the fact that creep wave is pushed in to the bottom lane and there is no one defending it has flagged a lot of warning bells.
But there's no Huskar there. They might not expect them. Are TNC really bold enough to fight 4 on 5?
Miracle's bold enough to fight in the bottom lane. He TP down there. Battled against Cuckoo for half a second. Now Notel, big avalanche, catching a couple, actually killing the Vengeful Throne. The relocate save out. He gets him away. The Searing Chains is holding the Void in position. BS, he'll be able to TP out. Void does actually have a Blink Dagger and a TP scroll, and he goes to the other side of the cliff face. But this means TNC are a long way away from Roshan, who just spawned up.
At least they'll have the Huskar this time, but that was... They almost caught OG off guard with that, because they certainly did not expect him to fight without the Huskar there. TNC intentionally showed Huskar on the lane so they wouldn't be prepped for a smoke, but crit there, the save today.
Range higher. He didn't even use Blink Dagger for that one. It was close enough anyway.
It might also be like so he can like relocate in and then not get caught by the Chronosphere. Because like oftentimes you'll see the places always like position the Chronosphere around the Tiny in such a way that the expected trajectory of the Wisp Tether
get
caught.
VS and Dro got caught out. And it was only really the Ember who was in any kind of danger. Notel just jumped in Viz nice and quick.
So now TNC looking for a fight around the Roche pit. They've sent the Hellbear Smasher inside the pit and they will get Wind of Fly trying to walk in there. But I don't really know how they respond to this. They're very far away from the pit.
Right now, Notel's trying to respond by killing off Raven. Walking up to the Dro Ranger. He's too far away, however. He needs to have the Ogre with him so he can toss him over.
Well, they just showed the Tiny, so they don't have enough damage to do Roche without the Tiny. Ember is, like, probably one of the worst mids at doing Roche.
It's still amazing how much money Notail's managed to accumulate. He's almost finished up. Is in fact, Courier, once it makes his trip out, he has the full Assault Cuirass. Very, very big Tiny. We also hit nighttime, so Notail can close the distance top lane. There's your Avalanche. Toss does not want to battle against Raven, however. Maybe he's just hoping to force a BKB charge out. There's still the 10-second BKB for Dro.
KBs will not help against the eternal struggle of pushing out their lanes.
It's amazing how much money OG is still getting when the lanes keep putting in. Like TNC, they're farming only lanes, they're not getting anything else. Moon just finished a Scythe of Vice. Gold advantage is now over 15,000 in favor of OG. Just keeps building and building.
And they don't really have any AoE to clear stacks fast. They don't have the mobility. Huskar's even having enough trouble keeping a TP in his inventory, let alone like blinks and other tools that OG can use to keep on farming. And yeah, as you mentioned, like the net worth is getting out of control, but there's always still that Huskar factor. Maybe he doesn't die in the fight.
Maybe OG doesn't find the perfect jump. But now they just don't seem to want to have any jump. They want to pick off like the scraps of the side of TNC. They're not even taking the risk of moving into Roshan, because if they go for that and TNC get a good chronosphere, they lock OG in a clustered area. Dangerous world for OG, and they give TNC a chance to potentially take racks. Momentum to a Huskar and Dro Ranger.
At the same time, the Roshan pit could be TNC's downfall. Like there's the Chronosphere on the side or the Radiant, but there's also the Darkseer vacuum wall onto that high ground. And without the Hurricane Pike, maybe with the Hurricane Pike down, maybe like Dry Ranger might get caught up there. Huskar can definitely get caught up there with that relatively long cooldown on Life Break. I don't know if he can use it twice in that short of a span.
I'm interested to see what Dro's buying up, and it looks like he's actually going to go for a Scotty. Judging by the Orb of Venom, which is on the Courier headed north. Demon's also approaching, but he's still another 600 gold away from having a full mech. TNC.
Okay, well, Demon has placed a strange Tinker Ward on the bottom lane, and it will see Moon, so they know that Moon's just chilling there in the trees.
Can't do much about him, however.
Yeah. Well, actually, they know that the gem's there, because that Sentry Ward just died. Bounce.
With the farming, there's that AC finally purchased. Daedalus on Miracle with another 2.7k, so everyone is just still item progressing. They've stalled this up a lot. Still have to stop for rolling in. Blink Dagger for the Ember. Another AC, this time it's going to come towards the Huskar. But he'll have to drop his TP scroll to hold onto this.
Didn't he have to know that? Oh, actually, that ward.
Miracle. Oh! Chrono barely missing! That's a difficult thing to gank an Ember. Normally is difficult when he's got a Blink Dagger against your Chronosphere, but to also gank Miracle, even more difficult. This guy uses 4 staffs to avoid Chronos.
Well, now, with that, it might be OG's time to go. Just waiting for one mistake from TNC.
TNC moving to the top lane. They're trying to find up here before Notail and Crit can reply to it. Crit's hit a long way back, and they're actually looking for Crit. Time dilation to start with. Notail will go invis. And the bottom lane is under siege. You can look for these kills up on top lane if they had spent all their time hunting Crit. He can still tether away, which he'll do up the hillside. Vengeful Spirit, hexed up by Moon. And they will just walk away.
Even with the Observer Ward and the Vision on OG, they cannot catch a break.
Why do I feel like we're just having a repeat of game one? The shoe is on the other foot.
Yeah, that's kind of how this game's going. OG just never refuse gold playing with their food.
Now TNC is really feeding them that much. And now it's time for Roshan. So OG, they have the confidence this time around just to slip into the pit. They have the damage because Titania is no longer on the top lane. Meanwhile on bot lane, and Miracle! That's a big one! Miracle will die! He's dead for a good 80 seconds, no buyback available. OG will at least have the advantage. They started Roshan before this happened, so TNC can't just move over and force an OG fight. would have been a good time for it as well. Chrono's coming back off cooldown in 10 seconds time. And they drove it on Noah. Actually, Miracle now actually has his buyback, but Notel caught out. They still have swap available, so if they want to hold Notel in close, they can do so. Faces Boy, Chrono's up, leans forward, doesn't have really a great target to go on, and the relocate is there. Crit will take him back. And they know Io is on the return.
I wonder if they're gonna like buy back Io and or buy back on Ember and spring a trap. Oh no!
They swap Fly hit. They're looking for more. They're actually gonna bring down Fly with a Huskar jump. Void moves over. Chrono onto Crit. They really are just committing for one kill or the other. They don't care as long as they get the kill, which they'll be able to do. So they get through the tier 2 tower. Buybacks available for all three players of OG, but their base is now under attack.
Buyback trying to scare TNC off, but without Miracle's name on the buyback.
And he comes! The big wall! Three men with the avalanche! Fly will arrive! They're buying time, still no Miracle! Pulls back, he has not done it yet, he's waiting in timeout. Kirker will battle against Crit. The cheese will keep him alive, also giving the regeneration to Notel, who's hunting the backline, keeping the no-range aura off of Kirker. He turns, Notel will drop, the Miracle is alive once again. And maybe TNC don't want to fight. The blink from Notel, he gets away, still gusted up. He'll get back to the tier 3 tower. Miracle looking to make the space moon again with another jump hit. But it's Cuckoo, it's the Huskar. You've got to fear him. Not to mention, fear Raven. That damage with a gust pushing Miracle away. The face is void on 30 life. He'll time walk off the damage. Raven in the trees. Notel will finally get a kill onto a TNC member. And Miracle will make it fly. Faceless Void dropping. Both TNC players, they have buyback too. But that patience from OG not bringing Miracle back in. Is Huskar actually out? He may go down. Tani's right behind him. He'll end up hitting him. Doesn't actually break the blood. The Cuckoo will stand his ground. Demon moves over, giving the extra armor. Now Notel. Does he fit? Not more than he can chew. With a shallow grave, you bet your Nelly. They're gonna go through more. Cuckoo, life break up in 2 seconds time. Flies in the tree line, thrown down by the Skadi. Miracle gusts it up! This could be huge if they can find him. Cuckoo, life break, he lost the vision. Miracle got it around the tree line. He'll blink himself down and TP out. They will not catch the Ember Spirit.
These have been some amazing gusts from Raven, though. Always catching the Ember Spirit off guard. And TNC sacrificed multiple lives to save their Huskar and expand a Drow buyback. But still, they were, you can see how close they were to winning that fight. The net worth difference maybe not looking as bad as it seems, 15,000 in favor of OG, but all started off with a pickoff on the Ember Spirit, so anything's still possible in this game.
And TNC showing some beautiful class. Even if you had them in your predictions down at number 16, like right now, they are showing high quality Dota neck and neck with a 2-time major winner OG.
Blink after the Aegis really saved them. They tried to time the gust, but he only got silenced. His blink didn't get disabled, and he was able to blink the other side of the fight where Huskar and Drow were not expecting him to be. If he just died a second time as an Aegis, like even if you buy it back, then like you're gonna lose that fight in terms of the economic damage.
Money on Cuckoo. He's looking for the last bit of money to pick up the Reaver, and that will give him his full Satanic. Huskar has already been a bit of a nuisance for OG to get in the fight. You were mentioning it as well, Melini. Just that one good shallow grave, the swap out, the timing for Huskar to survive. Now you add a Satanic to it. The damage increase needs to be there for Miracle. It actually looks like he's going for survivability, moving into a Skadi on him. Unless he's thinking about a Scythe Ember. Right now he should be thinking about an escape, which he does do so, all the way back home, away from the gank squad of TNC.
Even on top of the grave and the swap, they also have a pipe, a mech, like just all these small things that will help him survive.
Is Kurt trying to get these Observer Wards from TNC? There's another one on the top lane. We call them the Tinker Wards because you just look for the Tinker who hides in the trees. Now they're actually being used to scout out the Io. He sits a long way back waiting for a relocate save on the core in the lane.
It's also a very common place for Ember Spirits to hide as they're pushing out the lane and just waiting. Okay, they'll attack and then they'll slide and then they'll escape with Remnant or POTs or whatever it may be. So, you know, it's a lot of Faceless Void if he can actually catch him out and make use of them. We already saw the one with the one on Radiant's bottom, and it's a lot of investment if you don't actually get any kills.
Mid lane, Miracle is calling.
Three half damage.
Yeah. They had fortification available, but you don't want to burn it for just that. And you still got to defend your bottom.
TNC no longer had that Helm of Dominator creep inside the Roche pit. Still a couple minutes away, but they actually, he has Satanic, so no way to scout there. I don't know how they're going to approach a Roche pit without knowing when it's going to be up, when OG are taking it, how low the Roshan is.
You need to do the MVP strike. You just buy like multiple Helms of the Dominator, leave them on the couriers back at base, and you can hold on to your Dominator creep.
If only he were that rich. Drow Ranger might actually have to go for HOD. It's, Butterfly's pretty good too.
Build a Satanic on him too.
I think the Summoner Creep might actually be like that.
Oh, Chrono, top lane, Miracle caught out. Good timing on the Gust. Miracle held in position. He's down.
Not respecting
seconds.
The Void.
Yeah.
Oh, he got a Shadow Blade. That's why.
It slipped in.
It's like the best item to deal with a split pushing Ember Spirit, because if you're really quick, you can like, if he blinks and he chronos, he still has like a small cast point on the Chrono Spear, and then you can like slide into Remnant. But with the Shadow Walk, it's, you can just walk up, and then I think like some of the cast animation happens while you're invisible, and it's just much more difficult to dodge.
OG still aren't in a bad position. Like, they've always got buyback on the Ember Spirit where Miracle's making these plays. The bottom, it is still just down to one melee. You've got the mid lane and top tower. Like, they're both heavily injured. So it won't take much. In fact, you could just jump in with no telling crit with a simple relocate, and you'll already force TNT to fall back.
It's just a bad precedent to set, though. Like, your Ember Spirits has died twice now. Last time they opened up that mid fight, that was when OG had Aegis and Cheese. Now they don't have Aegis, they don't have Cheese, and now it's a long, even longer respawn on the Ember Spirit. Is he going to have to buy it back here? Are they going to have to lose a Rax? You don't want to be here.
They're trying to go for a trade off. Notel's going into the bomb. No, wait, they go for GG push. They're pushing onto the tier 4 towers. They put Cuckoo on the front lines, and they may have enough. Here's your buyback from the Ember. The bottom melee is not down just yet. They try and fight the Darkseer back wall. Not enough from Moon to keep TNC in the mix.
No tail split pushing bottom, melee wrecked already fallen.
This is a big advantage. The fact that TNC didn't take the mid, OG will have the lane equilibrium.
Who cares about Rax when you can go for Throne?
Is that what they're coming back in for again? The IO does have relocate, so Crit can bring Notel back at any time. And with Miracle up,
it might be a Throne race. Notel hitting on the D4.
Can they really do this? TNC went back in. They finished up the melee in mid. At least they get the counter, but then they actually go for the pull out to push back in again. A smoke. They're just looking for an advantage.
Just one more kill on Ember Spirit could be the end of this game. You don't want to be in that position. They trade a 1-for-1 Rax and an Ember Spirit buyback.
Mm-hmm.
So OG heavily underhanded at this point in the game. Especially with Roshan with another short respawn, just 15 seconds, and looks like AUM won't get wind of it. Nope.
And I'm loving this Observer Ward on bottom lane. Once again, the warning from TNC has been brilliant. They see the Tiny and the IO moving around, so Tiny under the cover of Shadow Blade, he'll move up, he'll find Vengeful Spirit, he'll toss him, but then the Chrono moving down. Crit was able to find the kill, Moon backing, trying to keep the face point out of the fight. Miracle enjoying his turn with a gun. It's on there for Raven. In fact, now it exposes Raven. They move over. Tiny is going to be Blink Dagger available. Void will instantly buy back. Even though Chrono was not available, I make OG think twice.
Oh, how was Moon there so quickly? Man. Yeah, that Grease, you have the Scythe that just instantly killed the faceless Void. No saving him from there. Now OG will be the benefactor of the very quick to respawn Roshan, and with an Aegis on Miracle, they are in small danger of losing this game.
This will be TNC's big test. They can't go out and contest Roshan. That is not possible. They have to defend high ground against Aegis, Cheese, OG.
Yeah, it's not a good spot. All of the work that they've done for the past 5 minutes setting up all those wards with the Shadow Blade reveal into the Chronosphere, everything now has been wasted after that.
It's also crazy to think they're played down mid, going for a full GG push, like attacking to tier 4 towers. The hilarious thing is, if they can keep enough alive and win a fight against OG inside their base, they can make a very quick push down mid.
They knew how to make OG panic though. Like, they're like, our D4 is under attack. You gotta buy that.
Yeah, do we go back and defend this?
That's what they really wanted though. They're just like, okay, now we just need the one mistake away from ending the game. Like, Ember Spirit getting caught at the edge of his base is not one mistake away, because he can still buy back and then, you know, so on and so forth. But they have to force multiple mistakes out from them. And, you know, they're one step forward, now one step back.
And they're really trying to do something about the Shadow Blade. There are 8 sentry wards over on Deem at the moment. Dust just got picked by the Faceless Floyd. Do not want to be caught with their pants down again.
Let's see, Drow Ranger maxing out on items. They're actually very slot challenged at this point. Huskarn, I guess, can still build a Hurricane Pike, but yeah, this is going to be a trial. They try and weather the Aegis.
The lines which are being drawn out right now, like the attack has been drawn down by Fly, but the exact line that we're going to walk on was just drawn out by Demon. They understand exactly where they're moving. OG will scan up towards the Aegis. They're expecting TNC to be trying to find more money, but right now TNC are waiting patiently inside their base.
And only 4 heroes without buyback at this point. One of them is very important to OG, one fairly important to TNC. I still think they can win a fight without the Faceless Void, but it'll require elimination of one of the OG cores. The site's also a little bit problematic. They have like all these defensive items, like the pipe and the mech and whatnot, but they don't actually have a Lotus Orb, which is one of the best counters towards the site device. And maybe one of the supports looking to build one, but I don't know, they don't have any money. They also need a safer buyback.
They're kind of flat broke at the moment. Demon did enough just to finish up the mech, let alone looking towards a Vengeful Spirit. She finished the pipe instead.
And like the Scythe is gonna be able to disable them for a long time. Combine that with like a vacuum wall afterwards. You have to like leave the wall, and that's a good 5-6 seconds where one of your important cores isn't doing damage, or Faceless Void just dies if he doesn't get a swap, which you ideally want to save with the Huskar. I don't know, they could pull some slick plays though. I can foresee them like going for like a swap into a Chrono or like a swap into a Gust.
Right now they use Raven as bait. Miracle almost biting. Good Negus the Immortal, so he doesn't really care that much. He's quite happy to initiate in. He'll always come back. No doubt the sentry saw him.
No opening.
He has BKB. He doesn't feel that scared. Now maybe even going for more shenanigans. BOT2s will be the item of choice for Huskar. Not opting for the Pike and not opting to replace the Armlet. So they're probably looking for like something cheeky with the Faceless Void here. BOTing onto him as he goes in for a Chronosphere. And you know, you're just looking to put OG in that precarious position where they're one mistake away from losing.
Oh, no tell. One hit is almost enough to kill the tower. Miracle gives it 2. Still at 1 HP, that tower. Nothing to work with at all. I'll end up denying it out. All the lanes being pressured. Moon was taking care of the bottom, and TNC, they're gonna try and find any kind of opening. They don't have everybody with them, however. The Huskar's not in the neighborhood, and they just walk into Notail. They'll break free. Tiny. Well, there's your Shallow Grave and a Chrono Spear. Notail's called out. Moon gonna try and freeze his face and back into a 3-man wall, pulling into Sam. But Raven's still the man doing the damage. You can keep him locked in, but now Raven the damage to Fly. Will it be enough? You need this short range to do some lifting. Fly will drop. 2 heroes on the sideline. They buy back on the BS almost finding the kill on the TPing out crit. Miracle also home safely. So that's 2 heroes down. Instant buyback comes out from the Tiny. Crit has relocate. So if they want to, they can just jump to the top lane. Fortification actually wasn't even burnt by TNC.
What a godly chrono from Sam. This is like one of the most high pressure situations that you're gonna be in as a Faceless Void. And he catches the 2 important cores. Ember Spirit on one end, Tiny on the other. And IO didn't seem to be close enough to go in for that relocate to save out the Tiny, and they will have to use a buyback. So that's a couple of deaths. They can just wait for Chrono to cool down. They weathered the Aegis, and now TNC back in a position of power.
See if they can hold the line for more time, however, and maybe control Roshan for the next time OG wants to slip over to it. Roshan's going to spawn up in 3.5 minutes, so again, another quick Roshan spawn time.
TNC have to keep their composure though. They have to make sure that a lot of things don't happen. They have to make sure that observer wards aren't in their base, so OG can't jump them with like even a sneaky relocate. They have to make sure that the lanes aren't pushed out so they can't backdoor with relocate. They have to make sure that OG doesn't get Roche. They have to make sure that Faceless Void doesn't die because he doesn't have buyback, nor does he have gold for the buyback. There's just so many things that could go wrong for TNC. Some are for OG. They have to make sure they don't get caught in Chrono. Most importantly, Tiny. And if like there's an excellent Chrono that like catches the Tiny and the Wisp, it could be a game over. Make sure Ember Spirit doesn't die. A lot of things. But they can play around the Faceless Void Chronosphere cooldown. I think that's actually the biggest thing on the side of TNC. He really needs to get a Scepter at this point, or Refresher maybe. probably gotten to the point where Refresher is slightly better than Scepter, just because of how late it is, and a minute might not even be short enough for that cooldown.
It's just so hard to find him that high level of farm. Where are you going to get it from? Like, right now, Husker and Dro Ranger are taking most of the farm, even if they don't really need it. Like, unless you're looking at a Moonchant purchase now from Raven so he can attack even faster, the Courier is making a trip up. I'd like to see what it's going to grab while OG look for a smoke gank. And I see a Demon Edge over on that Courier for Raven.
Rapier?
If he was going to buy a Rapier, he would have sold something else. Like, he's still going to sell the S and Y. He might just be looking for Monkey King Bar.
Yeah, Monkey King Bar versus the Solar Crest.
Bottom lane, Cuckoo, out too far. Hit by that Silver Edge. He'll have protection. BKB will come out. He needs more help, however, and it's coming in the void! He gets a three-man chrono, but they swap out Notel. It's all out Raven to attack into him, and Notel's so far away from the fight. The Tiny's down with no buyback. All that was lost was the BS in the void. But you're still okay with that. You keep your two primary sources of damage up, Cuckoo and Raven. They will survive.
Crit. Awfully close.
He has a blink and a TP available, yet he's still waiting. What is he waiting for?
I'm not sure. He has to have a plan of some sort.
Relocates a hero down to himself?
I'm not sure. Maybe he's looking for like a wisdom conclusion on someone, but I don't know who it would be. No one's really looking. He's going
Courier
for a
snipe?
Courier snipe.
That would be interesting to attempt.
Yeah, I think he's actually going to do it.
Demon just put down the Observer Ward, so he doesn't see him. He's not close enough. And the Courier, well, with the Creep Wave, one attack, two attack, three attack, TP, and Demon, the Shadow Wave damage. It won't be enough. Courier snipe is real.
Cargo worth zero, nothing of value was on that Courier. They can easily rebuy one, so not the biggest deal. I think their cores are almost six slotted anyways. So.
It's just the little things.
Yeah, the mind games. Miracle pressuring the left side. He has plenty of gold. Might be Reaper territory for him soon.
Okay, hello, Cuckoo. I think Miracle's gonna realize just how much damage Cuckoo can do, even without being low on life.
TNC are lacking so many items that would make this game so much easier for them. Scythe of Ice on the Ember Spirit would be crucial to killing him. Lotus Orb to deal with their own Scythe of Ice, like BKB, Scepter on the Faces Void. They're lacking a lot of items, but they're playing pretty well despite being at a significant disadvantage in net worth. They're still 20k in the hole, but it doesn't feel like it. The racks count is still even.
That's because TNC, they still have a lot to work with. Big amplification damage, great team fight control, a lot of sustain that comes from the VS and the Dazzle. All these things they keep using to, like, perfection. And it doesn't allow OG to finish it. All I want to see from Miracle is, yeah, there she is! We have ourselves a Rapier! Onto the Ember Spirit, we almost hit the hour mark as TNC, they'll enter the mid. Do they go for a GG push? Yep, they are! They're attacking the T4 tower, they're ready to jump forward! Chris, you need help now! That wall will be enough! Cuckoo's still there and the Chrono's here in part 2! Cuckoo right next to it! No shot's gonna go down! No buyback! They're going for the T4!
Wow, look at them cheering the booth. They have to be so incredibly happy with that win, and net worth does not matter that much anymore. Sam H with the Faces Void hit zero kills on him, but all of those Chronospheres on all of those cores, OG, eliminated on day number two of TI6, something that I would never imagine myself hearing.
I cannot believe